Well, hello and welcome back. So far, we have covered how to make interactions, how to structure layouts with grid and flex, how to use custom fonts, and so many other concepts you can explore in Droip. In today's session, we will see how to use our headers and footers on multiple pages with just a few clicks. So let's dive right into it. In our Droip, we have three pages today. All of them are missing a header, or let's just say a navbar and a footer. Creating a navbar or footer individually for each page is extremely time-consuming. Let's say we have a full-fledged website with over 50 pages. In that case, can you imagine how inefficient that would be? As it's an introductory video, we will start by creating a basic navbar. If you'd prefer to skip the beginner section, head straight to the timestamp provided in the description below. So, let's take a new page. Then we will have a section, a container, and a div. We will have a logo and a block for menu items. Give the navbar div a flex structure with justified content to space between. Also, let's just set padding for positioning the contents inside. Then let's set the logo and menu items. We used a symbol for the logo and placed a link block for the menu item. Let's just give the item a black color and then simply copy and paste two more times. Give the div holding the items a structure, that is flex, and horizontal gaps of 25 pixels. Alter the texts. Yes, pretty much that's all about it. Let's do a thing. Link the link blocks to the corresponding pages. Link settings, page, select page, about, and similarly, let's do the others as well. We are almost there. Let's make the header a symbol. Now let's visit the symbol library, header, then navbar, and add conditions. Add new conditions. Where to apply? Let's just select pages for now. You can select all pages or maybe a single one as well. Let's just go with all and apply. That's it. Let's go back to the about page now. Yes, it's properly placed. Let's run it, click project. We are taken to the project page and the page has the navbar according to the condition we set. And also, let's check the contact page as well. Yes, and now let's just do the same thing for the footer. Symbols, footer, add conditions, new condition. Let's just do the entire site this time. Save and run. And yes, all the pages are having header and footer now. See how easily you can make a smooth navigation and use components like a breeze. Also, you can use conditions according to your preference. And with that, we wrap up today. We are truly coming with something exciting ahead. So, stay tuned.